Father's Day gift, so I'm good for about a
Yeah, but your grandmother, you gave her three times. Does he know that?
Does he know what?
That you gave your grandmother her gift three times.
Oh, the flowers, yes! The flowers that no one could find, and then all these bouquets arrived, and I was $200 poorer. My husband will never forgive me for that one. He's like, why do I have $200 in charges and flowers? And I'm like, just keep walking. Stop, just keep walking. Don't ask questions. But she's worth every penny. All right, now let's see. Okay, let's settle down because I'm all giddy that my dad's here. So those of you that just came in, the guy that looks like Santa Claus in the back is my daddy. So he's here from Ohio. And I twisted his arm and here he is. So took a little twist. And again. So I'm not gonna tell any stories today. No, I'm just joking. All right, so my name is Beth. I own Wellness 360, where we do physical therapy, group fitness for disease management, and massage therapy. So if you'd like my business card or have any questions about wellness classes that we offer or massage or any of the above, please see me after class. I always carry my business cards. And somebody, you can toss a dime, someone here knows how to get a hold of me if you need to. So the rules for chair yoga, if you are new, is do everything in your comfort zone, and if it hurts, don't do it. All right? You don't have to force yourself to be anyone or do anything that you're not in here. You are safe. You are here to be exactly who you are in this moment and just to feel better when you leave. So let's get comfortable in our chairs. We're going to open up with some breath work. So we're going to close our eyes. Hi, how are you? Close our eyes and we're going to take a nice deep breath in. And a nice full breath out. One more time, nice deep breath in. And a nice full breath out. I want you to take just a moment to scan from your head all the way down to your feet. Notice if you're holding on to any muscle tension, and if you are, I want you to take this moment to breathe in through the nose and surround that area with a bunch of oxygen. And as you exhale, give your body permission to exhale out anything that does not serve purpose to you in this moment. So that could be pain, discomfort, muscle tension. Relaxing your muscles from your head all the way down to your feet. Noticing the connection of the earth to your feet. Noticing the connection of yourself to the chair. And with your eyes still closed, just drop your hands down to your side. And I just want you to take this moment to inhale, both arms up and overhead. Reaching up towards the ceiling and exhale, both arms down. And again, inhaling up, arms to the sky. And exhaling down, all the way down. Let's take that right arm and reach it up towards the ceiling. Big reach here. You should feel this from your fingertips all the way down your side. And bring it back down. Other side, reach it up. And bring it back down. One more time each side. Reach. And lower. And reach. And lower. Let's take some neck circles. So take your chin down towards your chest and kind of just let your head hang here. And then we're going to roll it to the left and to the right. Really gentle. We're only doing half rolls here. So chin to chest, and then we're going to roll our left ear towards our left shoulder, and then our right ear towards our right shoulder, back and forth. What I want you to be mindful of here is that your ear is going towards your shoulder. It's not the other way around. Keep your shoulders down and relaxed. And then roll to the back. Again, side to side. You may notice there's a lot of muscle tension in the front of that neck from that forward posture. But just take your time and relax the shoulders with your breath. And now let's do full circles, chin to chest, and circle it around. Full circles forward and back. Anytime we're doing neck work, we always want to work within your comfortable range of motion. Reverse to the other side or the other direction. And bring it back to center. Let's take our shoulders and let's squeeze our shoulders forward. And then open them up. Open up that chest, squeeze your shoulders behind. If you're lucky, you'll get a couple snap, crackle, and pops in there. Forward and open. We're gonna make this a little bigger by taking our arms and moving them forward and then opening them up. Squeeze your shoulder blades nice and tight together. If you happen to slap your neighbor, just scoot yourself to the side a little. This is not boxing class. And open. And forward, and open. One more time, forward, really press it forward. Push those fingertips as far away from your body as you can, and then squeeze your shoulder blades together, open up nice and big, palms facing front, and release down. Big shoulder rolls for me. Back. And forward. I'm not a big fan of the forward roll, but it does feel nice. Why encourage the same posture we're in every day? All right, great job. Come to the edge of your seat. You're gonna open up your knees, hands are on your knees. You're gonna take your right shoulder and you're gonna press it into the center of your body as far as you can comfortably, and bring it back to center, and switch. Boy, I hope the rain holds off today. And switch.
It's not going to. Not according to rain.
Terry, where's that positive thinking? Where's that positive thinking? And back.
Well, the radar, Doppler radar, is coming about 12:30 because I was going to call.
I want to remind you of that one time that we all meditated on sunshine, and at the end of the meditation, the clouds cleared and the sun was out. You remember that one? I want to remind you of that time, Terry. Side to side. And bring it back. Now you're going to take your chest forward, look up towards the ceiling, really push your belly forward, rock your pelvis, and then pull your belly button in and curl your body. And open. And close. And open, and close. One more time, open, and close, and stack it up nice and tall. Right hand to right knee, left hand opens up. Big rotation here. And you're going to take palm up and you're going to slide it under your hand here, under behind your right hand, like you're threading a needle. And then slowly open it up, nice and big. Nice and big. And bring it back. And press. And open, and one more time, thread that needle, and we're gonna take two full breaths here. Nice breath in, nice full breath out, and bring it back up. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So, left hand to left knee, take that right hand, open it really big, big rotation here. You're gonna take that hand, you're gonna thread the needle behind your left hand. Full exhale here, really ring out those lungs. And open up, really big here. And exhale all the way through. And bring it in. And last time, we're gonna hold this for two breaths. Thread that needle. Nice inhale. And exhale. And bring it back to center. All right, we're gonna do the cat-cow. So what the cat-cow is, you pull your belly button in, you pull your shoulders forward, and you arch your back. And then you push your belly forward and look up towards the ceiling. It's a little more aggressive than the one we did before. Really rock that pelvis. Pull the belly button in, push the shoulders forward, and then open up one more time. Great job, back to a neutral spine. Inhaling, arms up and overhead. Grab your right hand to your left wrist and give it a gentle pull. And bring it all the way back up and release it down. This time you're gonna take that left hand across the body and give it a gentle pull. This one can be really confusing. So just your left hand across your body, right hand gives it a squeeze. Here, and here, here,
left hand,
here,
yep.
Left hand across the body,
left hand across, pull
right
the
hand on the elbow,
pull the right
hand, and pull. Beautiful. No, you're not. Trust me, they've all been here before. We've done this one too many times. And release. Take that left thumb down and bring it behind your back. If you have shoulder issues, this could be very uncomfortable, so do not force this motion. Sitting up nice and tall. See if you can relax that shoulder. See a lot of hiked shoulders. See if you can relax that shoulder down. And then slowly release that hand and slowly come out from behind the back. Shake that arm out. Notice the difference in your right and left hand. Your left hand feels about 4 inches longer. All right, inhale up, grab a hold of your right hand and pull it across the body here. Nice deep breath in. As you breathe in, I want you to really pay attention to your ribs and your side. So as you inhale, feel the ribs expand to allow all that room for your lungs to expand. And bring it down, all the way down. Very nice. All right, everyone, take your right hand across your body. And then left hand up to the elbow. And just give it a pull. No man left behind here. No man left behind. Good, everyone looks good. And release, shake it out. Take your hand out to the side, thumb down, and come behind the back and give it a gentle pull, nice and gentle.
My chair's in the way.
Yeah, you have to scoot up a little bit, but these are slippery chairs, so don't go for a ride to the floor. And slowly release that arm, nice and slow, all the way down, shake it out. All right, great job. Okay, we're gonna open up our knees and you're gonna take your hands, inhale them up. We're slowly moving down the body. We're gonna exhale, pull forward as far as you can. Push those hands forward, 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 all the way down to the floor. I want you to hang up here for just a second, a nice deep breath in. Nice full breath out. then slowly start with the pelvis. Tuck the pelvis under and roll your body up one vertebrae at a time. Shoulders are the last thing to lock into place. Head and neck up, hands come open. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Now, my friends, this is good posture. Obviously, you're not gonna walk around with your hands like this, but the shoulders and the head and the neck, this is where we should be in life. Inhale up. Reach your hands forward, all the way forward, as far as you can. Really stretch out those glutes, hamstrings, and low back. You may notice you've got a little further to the ground this time. Maybe not, maybe so. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. Think about that pelvis, tuck your pelvis under and roll it up. Pull your belly button into your spine. Feel that spine roll up one vertebrae at a time. Lock the shoulders into place. Sit up nice and tall and feel how this feels. You'll need to adjust your mirror, your rear view mirror in the car when you leave. You'll be so much taller. All right, this time we're gonna take our right hand and you're gonna reach your right hand as far as you can forward. Left hand is gonna open up all the way behind you. And hold. And bring it back. Then you're gonna take your left hand and reach it forward as far as you can and open up your right hand to the back. Nice inhale, nice exhale, and bring it back down. Switch again, push that hand, and as you push that hand, your body naturally rotates. So don't just push your hand like this. Push your hand as far as you can reach, like you're trying to reach for something on your countertop. And bring it back. And then really reach forward with that left hand as far as you can, pushing your shoulders into a rotation. And then open up. And fully release here. We're going to take both of your legs out front. Now, I will warn you, this chair is very, very slippery. So you want to find the fine line between not falling out of your chair and falling out of your chair, all right? So my advice is to not fall out of your chair, all right? So dig those heels in. Legs are going to be straight. You're going to walk your hands nice and gently down your legs as far as you can go comfortably, feeling safe in your chair. Please don't be the first. The first is not always the good place to be. And you're gonna walk your hands back up your legs one at a time, sitting up nice and tall. Very good. Okay, we're gonna do it again. We're walking our hands down, keeping that spine nice and straight. You may notice that you're able to get just a little further than before. I don't like that sound, Maureen. I don't like that sound. Nice inhale. Nice full exhale. And we are done with this. Too many people are grabbing their chair. All right. So let's do a single leg. So let's keep your right leg out. Bring your left leg back to give you some stability. All right. Let's do that. And we'll take both of our hands and reach down towards that leg. Now, while we're here, I want you to close your eyes. I want you to really focus on the breath. I want you to envision that breath coming in through the nose, all the way surrounding that right hip, the right hamstring, which is in the back of your leg. I want you to straighten that leg as straight as you can get it without locking your knee. Some of us may be so tight you can't even straighten that knee. So just work on getting that knee nice and straight and then slowly bring it back up. All right, now we're gonna take our right hand and just our right hand is gonna go down towards the leg as our left hand is gonna go up towards the sky.
Easy for me to say.
Easy for me to say. Nice couple deep breaths. What happens when we get in these difficult positions is we start to hold our breath. When we hold our breath, it puts us in what's called the sympathetic nervous phase, and that is our fight or flight. So what I want you to do while you're in this position that's a little uncomfortable, I want you to really focus on breathing. Breathe in nice and deep, and breathe out nice and deep. And then sit yourself back up. It sounds a little silly, but that transitions into real life. Let's switch sides. When you start to go through a difficult position, you come back to this moment. Breathe in and breathe out. Both hands walking down the leg. Working on getting that knee as straight as you can. Again, we don't lock out our knee. Just nice and straight. Breathing in, breathing out, finding that nice and smooth, full breath. And bring it up nice and tall. We're gonna do that again. Slide down that leg. If you're having a real difficult time with discomfort, you can always brace yourself on your other leg with your forearm. So you're not going into a full stretch, and you can control how much you give. Nice deep breath in. Nice full breath out. And slowly bring it up. Slide that foot in. All right, we're gonna go back to the right side, but how we're gonna start is we're gonna inhale, arms up and overhead. Reach up for the ceiling as far as you can. You're gonna hinge forward all the way down. Let your arms hang down to your side. And you're gonna slowly roll it up. But as you come up, you're gonna bring that right knee in towards your chest. So give that a nice squeeze in towards the chest. If you've had a knee surgery, have really bad arthritis, have range of motion, this might be tough. You can always grab underneath your leg if that feels more comfortable. And as always, you can take a pause and come back when you're ready. All right, so now we're gonna kick that leg out. All right, hold underneath that leg here. And we're going to pump our ankles. Bring the toes back, straighten them forward. Bring them back and forward. While you do this, you may get they're called zingers. You may feel like a little spike of discomfort while you do it. Just say hello to your sciatic nerve. This is a great stretch if you have sciatica or any kind of sciatic pain. All right, and now let's make this fun because that's what we do in this class. And we hold. And we hold. She's gone mad. All right, slowly lower down, slowly lower down. Good job. See, you guys are gonna be pros at this in no time. All right, inhale, arms up and overhead, reach up towards the ceiling as high as you can. Forward fold, all the way forward, hands down towards the floor. And slowly roll it up one vertebrae at a time. Scoop up the other knee. That's my code for I couldn't remember which one it was. The left knee. Hold the left knee. Give it a nice squeeze. I have myself so confused because I mirror you. So sometimes it's left, sometimes it's right. It's my left, your right. I can't remember which side mine is to tell you which side yours is. All right, let's scoop underneath this leg and straighten that leg out. Nice ankle pumps here. You may find one side is much more tight than the other side. There is nothing wrong with you. It's perfectly normal. It actually would be abnormal for both of your sides to be loose. All right, a couple more times here, and just for the fun of it,
that's fun.
We have to You're welcome. That's my gift to you. Inhale up. Exhale, reach forward. All the way down. We're going to roll it up one vertebrae at a time and scoop in that right knee. Nice and high. Shoulders back, neck long. There you go. That looks beautiful. All right, we're going to do some ankle pumps, ankle circles here. Just give your ankles a little TLC. I promise no more tricks for now. Can't promise later. Good job. Crisscross that right ankle over the left knee. Come to the edge of your seat if you feel comfortable. Now remember, this could be difficult. Some people might not even be able to crisscross. So I want you to listen to your body here. We're going to start by gentle overpressure, pressing that knee down and towards the ground. If you don't want to use your wrist, you can use your forearm and just kind of lean into it. But push with love. There's no reason to push hard or against the body because you're just going to be fighting against your own body and fatigued and no one's going to win. So close your eyes, take a nice couple deep breaths here. And then we're going to scoop that knee in towards the body, sitting up nice and tall. Stretching the hip just from a different angle. You're going to take your left hand towards your right knee, and you're going to open your right hand up with a nice and gentle twist. You're going to take a couple breaths here. If you can't crisscross your knees, if you just want to do it this way, that's perfectly fine too. Great job. All right. I promise no more tricks, but I kind of lied. What I'm going to have you do is I'm going to have you take your right hand under your right knee. I want you to scoop your left hand under your ankle. And I want you to pull. It's not really a trick, but it's not easy.
It's easier when you go back to your back.
Yeah. All right, relax it down. Chest is up nice and high. We're going to hinge forward, all the way forward. I want you to get comfortable in this pose because we have about three breaths, full inhales and exhales we're going to do here. One breath in. One breath out. Two breaths in. And out. And three breaths in. And out. And slowly press into your leg and sit up nice and tall. Give that knee just a squeeze, relax it. Maybe take your whole ankle and foot and go side to side. Just kind of wiggle out that hip joint. There is not a whole lot of rotation here, so if you don't have a lot of motion, that's perfectly normal. And before we move on to the other leg, because I don't know about you, but my hip flexors sore from that move. So we're going to take our body and we're going to face the left hand of our chair. So move your whole body facing the left side. We're going to drop that front leg or that right leg, knee towards the ground. Now for this one, it's really hard, especially if you have good shoes, to get your foot back there. So lean forward in your chair and press that foot back as far as you can, and then sit up nice and tall here. So, chances are, caution tape here, you could get a hamstring cramp. So I want you to kind of wiggle your ankle left and right, see if you can relax those muscles, and see if you can just let that hip joint kind of sag down towards the floor. Nice little gentle distraction here. We're going to inhale the right hand up towards the ceiling. Nice deep breath in here. Nice full breath out. One more time. Nice deep breath in. Nice full breath out. And keep that hand overhead, but I want you to press your knee down towards the floor, but press your fingers towards the back of your chair. So it's towards the back of the room. So you're just doing a big, huge stretch to your hip flexor, to your side, to your rib cage. I want you to hold this pose with a nice deep inhale. Feel your rib cage expand. Nice full exhale as you bring your hand back up towards the ceiling. All right, if you feel comfortable, I want you to press your left hand towards the front of the room, the right hand towards the back of the room. So you're in this sideways warrior two modification here. Your hands are going to be parallel to the floor. So you can look back and forth, see how parallel you think you are. It's not our job to correct our neighbors. Just pay attention to yourself. Take that front hand, flip it palm up, and tip it back. If you can touch your back heel, awesome. If not, no biggie. Nice deep inhale. Nice full exhale. Bend your left elbow and come down to your left knee, and right hand goes up behind. Stretch that hand up, and I see a lot of us are like this. What I want you to do is press your shoulder and hand back and really rotate that whole torso and open up that hip flexor. For those of you who do a lot of sitting, these are excellent exercises for you. Take this right hand from the ceiling down towards the floor and up towards the ceiling. We're going to do just a couple big rotations here. For one and two. Binding that hip together. And we're going to scoop that knee up and pull it across the body. Sitting up nice and tall, pulling that knee across the body. And you should feel a nice stretch here in the side of your hip, maybe in your glutes a little bit. Let's take that left hand, palm faces up, and we rotate away. Nice deep inhale, relax those shoulders, nice full exhale. And we bring it back. Here's the funny business. Scoop under this knee, scoop under the ankle, and lift that leg up towards your chest the best that you can. And then place that back down, chest nice and high. You're gonna hinge at the hips, chest towards that bent knee. And this one is the best stretch in the entire universe for anyone that has low back pain, glute pain, sciatica pain, SI joint dysfunction, you name it. So for this one, I want you to close your eyes. We're gonna hang out here for 3 full breaths. So bring your attention back to that hip joint and take a nice deep breath in. Nice full breath out. And 2 more times, nice deep breath in. And out. Kind of melt into this pose, last breath, nice deep breath in. Nice full breath out. Sitting up nice and tall. Give that knee 1 more hug and just wiggle that whole lower extremity, that internal and external rotation of the hip. Just let that relax. And we're just gonna slowly lower it down. And now we're gonna move to the right side of our chair. And we're gonna drop that left knee down towards the floor. Remember to hinge forward, press that leg back. And then sit up nice and tall. Relax your shoulders. You can hold on to the back of the chair if you're a little fearful of sliding out the front of your chair. Nice deep breath in. Nice full breath out. Taking that left hand up towards the ceiling. Nice and high, shoulders down, palms are, or fingertips are up. Breathing in, we're breathing out. Take that hand and reach towards the back of the room. This is a big hip flexor stretch on this side. Sitting up nice and tall, palms towards the ceiling, and then we're gonna open it up again into that warrior two. So I want you to take a nice look at your palms behind you and forward. Press your shoulders down and back. Squeeze those shoulder blades together, tummy tight. Head up nice and high. And breathe. Let's take that hand, palm faces up, that right hand. And we're going to just hinge backwards. If you can touch the back heel, great. If not, just hold it here for 1 full breath. And hinge forward, bend that front elbow, elbow towards the knee, and really reach up. Taking that hand, we're gonna swoop it down towards the floor. And then rotate it all the way up. Again, exhale all the way down. Inhale all the way up. And bring yourself up to a tall position and just pull that knee under and move your knees to the front of the room. We're gonna go just through a little flow. Are you stuck back there? All right, inhale, arms up and overhead. Exhale, down. We're going to inhale, hands, palms are going to face forward. Inhale, palms come back. We're going to take a big scoop, and we're going to go forward again. So you're just coming down, hands continue, roll it up, arms behind, squeeze those shoulder blades all the way up, big, big, big circles. One more time, down, and roll it up. Once we get to the top, we're going to reverse this. We're going to take our hands, palms open, and down, scoop, and big and open, down. One more time, big and open, and down, and bring it up. And exhale our hands all the way down to the side for our final meditation. It's over. Get comfy in your seats. Our final breath work here. We're gonna close our eyes and just kind of relax into our chair. So we're gonna breathe in really, really deep through the nose. And we're going to fully exhale. Nice full deep breath in. And exhale. We're going to finish up today's session with circle breathing. So bringing your attention to your heart center, I want you to inhale through the heart center. And as you exhale, move your thoughts to your left shoulder. Inhale to the left shoulder. Exhale to the left hip. Inhale to the left hip. Exhale to the navel. Inhale to the right hip. Exhale to the right shoulder. And a full inhale and exhale at your heart center. One more time, inhaling left shoulder. Exhaling left hip. Inhale left hip. Exhale to the belly button. Inhale at the belly button. Exhale to the right hip. Inhale to the right shoulder. Exhale to the heart center. And for just a moment, I want you to hold a sense of gratitude in that heart center. Think of someone, or something, or an event, or something that just brings you great pride and great gratitude. Hold that close to your heart and inhale nice and deep to your heart center. And a nice full exhale. Relaxing your arms down to your side, shake it out, your fingers. Inhaling both arms up, palms come together, exhaling to heart center. The spirit in me respects and honors the spirit in each and every one of you. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you so much for joining me again. I'm Beth from Wellness 360. here for your physical therapy and massage therapy needs. It was so great to have you all. And for Terry, I hope the rain stays off and the beer of plenty. Thank you so much.